Yeah, hi there. These comments are for NA, and I am Michael, the founder, owner, and the materials writer for all of your lessons at the 7-step system to pass a TOEFL IBT. All right, let's get right to your questions. So you're having some questions about the listening and speaking sections of the TOEFL IBT. Here's your question one. What is the required time for answering each question after listening to a conversation or a lecture in the listening section, since ETS just says about the total time for the listening part will be 60 to 90 minutes. All right, so here it is. Okay, usually you will have 3 or 4 recordings. After each recording, you'll have a set of, maybe 15 to 17 questions. So you'll have approximately 10 minutes, if you're pacing yourself, to answer these questions. That's going to give you about 35 seconds per question. So imagine you listen to a lecture. After the lecture's over, remember, you're taking notes. After the lecture's over, you will see the questions. I would say you want to take approximately 35 seconds for each question. And remember that you cannot go back and look at questions before or after. You have to answer the questions in the order that you see them. Right? So most students really don't have too much trouble finishing the listening section. So to answer your question directly, you'll probably need approximately maybe 20 to 35 seconds of time per question. Answer the questions in order that you see them. All right? So that's my answer to that. Now the next question is, you say in integrated speaking, part 3, I often miss speaking about the major points of lecture or conversation. In this case, can I shorten my speech about the reading passage, since some other books and sites explain the importance of longing the speech or lengthening the speech, you want to say, for the listening part other than for the reading? I'm having a hard time taking notes about important pieces of information. Okay, well, let's answer your question. Okay, the main thing here is in Integrated Speaking 3, you'll have a notice, you'll have some type of informal kind of a idea in a reading passage that's campus related, and then you will probably have a student or students discussing that information, right? So I would say the reading is not that difficult. I would jot down maybe 1 or 2 maybe key ideas about the reading passage. Put those on the left side of the notebook paper that you have. On the right side, you want to jot down the most important point and support points of the listening passage. Put those on the right side of your paper in note form. The key here is you're getting the notes from the reading and the listening passage on the same page so you can see them. Right? So then once you've done that, it's easy for you to create your introduction, I think, for Integrated Speaking 3, because you're simply connecting the main point of the reading passage with the main point of the listening passage. You're showing the relationship. For example, let's say that you listen to a reading passage about some changes in the campus cafeteria. In the listening passage, the students discuss the new changes. And maybe the cafeteria is extending its hours. It's having later hours for students so that they can eat later on in the night or earlier in the morning, right? So then if you had a topic here or you wanted to create the introduction for this, it might be something like this. You might say the reading passage discusses a scheduling change for the campus cafeteria, and in the listening passage, 2 students discuss that change. That's it. That's how you do it. Okay, so let's go back to your other information here. It says, I am having a hard time taking notes about important pieces of information. Most of the time, I cannot differentiate between major and minor points and mess up in taking notes. It says, although I watched your video lectures on note-taking, I got frustrated after taking notes, and it usually affects my speech in the speaking part. I cannot finish my speech within the required time limit. Please help me. Okay, the main thing here is, remember that for Integrated Speaking 3, you have 60 seconds, right? You have 60 seconds to briefly explain a notice about something related to the university. You have also some time to talk about students who react to that notice or whatever the case might be. So you should be able to finish this. Part of it is it's improving your delivery. If you can improve, really, there's a couple of areas that you can improve in that help you speak faster. One of them, I think, is sentence rhythm, where you're putting more stress on your nouns, adjectives, adverbs, and verbs. You're putting less stress on your determiners, auxiliary verbs, and prepositions. So if your sentence rhythm is good, that also can allow you to speak a little bit faster. But another one which is very important for your speaking speed and fluency is thought groups and blending. So I think that you submitted a practice test the other day. So what you have to do is you have to have fewer pauses, fewer hesitations when you're speaking. So your goal here is to pause after 4 or 5 stressed syllables. You have a short pause, then you put together another 4 or 5 stressed syllables, followed by another pause. If you follow that basic rule of thumb, that's going to help you speak faster. And if you can improve your sentence rhythm, that also helps. Now, one other thing that's important with your pacing, your thought groups and blending, is you want to blend the words within the thought group. And that sounds very natural, and it also allows you to speak faster. Right? So if I said the professor handed out the research assignment, that's too many pauses. Now, if I take handed out and put it together, I might say the professor handed out the research assignments. You see what I'm saying? So there's no pauses in there, really. The professor handed out the research assignments. You see what I'm saying? So if you can work on that, and I think this is... If you go to the pronunciation area of my course, focus on sentence rhythm and also thought groups and blending. Those two areas can help you to speak faster. Now, what you can do is right now, if you cannot finish your speech within the required time limit, take more time. Take 70, take 80, take 90 seconds. Now, when you record it, I will give you some information. I will tell you how you can shorten that speech so it fits the required time limit. And that can help you with your pacing. You see what I'm saying? So that those are some of my suggestions for you that I think can help you to improve your speaking speed. Right? So those are my answers to your questions. So I hope that in this video, I've given you some good information to help you improve your listening and speaking performance on the TOEFL exam.